Hello race of gamers! This video is about my first impression of a game called Allods Online, a game that was released in 2010. One that hoped to dethrone World of Warcraft, the king of MMORPGs back in the day, and still on the first spot even today. It aims so high, but forgetting it is a WoW clone at its core. Let's see what is Allods Online, and if it is a successful copy, or just one that got forgotten by time. Before we start, I would appreciate if you would feed the algorithm beast with a like on this video. It will help me in the fight with it. Also, if you enjoy the content, consider subscribing. Let's talk about character creation and classes. Well, like any other MMORPG, Allods Online starts with me picking a race and a class. For a first glance at it, I was impressed. We have plenty of races to choose from. We have the classic ones like humans, orcs, elves, and some unique ones like Arisen. There seems to be some occult fanatic type of race. We have also the Pridans, that are like a fenrir type race, and on the other hand, we have the Gibberlings, a cute trio of some fluffy yordle-like creatures. Just look at them and how they try to be fierce, still being so cute. I couldn't handle myself and chose this race and picked a warrior in an ironic way. The customization of the character is nothing deep, like Black Desert, but it is okay for an old game. You have some kind of details to play with, and for my Gibberlings, it was cool that I could customize each one of them. So, after I finished their style, I jumped into the game. The game starts with a prologue. Here, I have to do some quests and kill some bad guys, some monsters, and escort an NPC. After that, I am teleported to the starting zone of the Gibberlings. It's cool that every race has its own starting zone, and you'll get a different experience from playing each one. And, of course, the game has auto-pathing. At least, when I click on it, the game throws a thread ball for my character to run after it, and this trio of yordle look very funny when doing so. The game combat is top-targeted and doesn't have any telegraph attack to dodge. It is kinda bland, but at least you have many skills to use. Also, they have global cooldown. One thing that I observed about the combat mechanic is that you can't shoot arrows or projectiles through walls, and that is somewhat logic, but few games have this feature implemented, and I think it is an important one, especially in PvP. A feature that I absolutely like, and I want it to be present in more games, is underwater combat. The best until today, I found in Guild Wars 2, but Allods Online is able to deliver a standard target action combat in this environment too. It's cool to be able to fight some aquatic creatures and have missions around that, or just kill some random barracudas. What I would like from the game would be flying type action too, but I think I asked too much already. The skill tree in this game is pretty basic at first, with some skill page that unlocks more when you put points into them. After further inspection, I saw that from level 10 you can specialize some points from another 3 pages that give you passive upgrades for your skills. And at level 70, I saw that you have another passive skill tree, something like a Path of Exile 1, but I didn't really get into that much, but from these aspects, you can customize your character a little bit, and you don't really feel that you have just a few abilities and that's all. But one thing that I have to say though, is the animation on them are pretty basic and bland, at least for my warrior class. Let's check the story and the questing system. Allods Online has some sort of story, but you can't really see it at early levels, but from what I read on the internet, the main one is still getting updates. A big plus for this game is that the quests are really different and engaging enough. You have your traditional kill and collect quests, but also, you have some that require you to help some citizens, catch some fish, find stones, use quest items in order to attract monsters, and a lot of different kind of things to do. One mission that I remember in particular was one where I had to wash some veterans with a sponge in a public sauna or something similar. It was a funny one to do and did not expect that to be in the game. I know the game copies WoW, but in this area, a lot of MMORPGs should do this too. The game progression is a little bit slow in my opinion, but then again, the classic WoW experience was like that, maybe even slower. So I got no complaints here, and I really enjoyed the leveling experience till endgame in an MMORPG. I see it as a single player game. What ruined it for me is the XP boost I got that I accidentally clicked and got 2 or 3 levels from that, and I was a little too strong then for the monsters where I had to quest. It was an instant turn off for me. It's understandable that endgame matters mostly, but I don't want a rushed experience for that. I don't want to be max level and don't know what I have to do after that if I don't have anybody to ask. Let's check the atmosphere and the environment. In terms of the feeling, the game has a really good fantasy vibe to it, with different kind of environments, from hills to deserts to snowy regions to big castles and much more. The graphic of the game looks good too, despite being such an old game. This is a good thing with animated graphic style, it ages well like a good wine. About the immersion of the game, it really got me into it. You have changing weather, like in the forest when it suddenly started to rain, and that really got me excited because you don't see this kind of feature in a lot of MMORPGs. So, the game, in my opinion, is pretty atmospheric and really got me hooked. I even saw some player base, although not a really big one, but an existing one and pretty active, especially in the main city. There, you can see a lot of really cool looking mounts and great outfits. So, if you have someone to play the game with, maybe you should give it a try. About dungeons, I don't really got to experience them. I had a particular quest to beat one, but I had no party to do it. Okay, let's talk about what I liked and disliked about Allods Online. But before we do that, you can support and motivate me into making new videos about what games to play and what to skip by pressing the subscribe button. By doing this, you will be part of the legacy that I want to leave in this world. Let's create a big gaming community. Also, you can help in the fight with the algorithm beast by feeding it with likes on the video. If you think I missed something or have other opinion about what I said, feel free to comment. I would like to hear your opinion or to give me some indication about the game. And don't forget, I try games so you don't have to waste your time. So, what I liked about Allods Online is that although it feels like a WoW clone at its core, it is still a good game with plenty of things to do in it, plenty of classes and races to pick from, engaging kind of quests and immersive zones to explore. What I find kind of boring was the combat, but maybe only on my warrior or other melee classes it feels like it. I don't really have anything major to complain about the game, and it really is pretty fun. In conclusion, I will say it again, if you can find a friend to play with or maybe join a guild, the game may be worth your time. Okay, so this will wrap it up today's video. Thank you guys for watching, and may the gods of good rap be with you in your grindy days. If you want more videos about games, feel free to check my channel. See you next time.